Hey!
What up, guys? I know we're all excited to see this Kotski conference call that's about to go down, but before we do that, we gotta let our sponsors get a shout-out, and today's video is sponsored by Loot Crate!
Loot Crate!
So, we've got a past Loot Crate. If you guys get a Loot Crate, you're gonna be getting next month's Loot Crate, obviously, so we're gonna crack it open and see what's inside of it. Also, we're really excited to see the Kotski leader. Tell me that guy, he wouldn't want a Loot Crate. He probably would. He's a crazy person.
Loot Crate opening jutsu!
Here goes the loot crate.
Ooh.
This is a great, great box. You can actually use the box itself and make like a cool item. So I wonder what theme this one is. I love opening these boxes. Yay, it's the cereal box one. So there is an awesome Bugs Bunny Looney Tunes shirt. It's an XL.
Hey, ready, baby.
Every loot crate comes with a pin and Runa collects the crap out of these. We have like all tons of these.
This is the older loot crate. If you sign up with Normies 15 discount code, you will get 15% off.
And you'll get the next month's one that I'm probably also excited about.
The holidays are coming around, guys. You could just get that certain nerd in your life a loot crate for their holidays, honestly.
The best box out there is probably Loot Crate monthly one, period, hands down. So please use our code, which is right here, right below. Please use it. Get yourself a monthly box. I'm telling you, you're not gonna regret it. Like, this is, I love it. I love Loot Crate.
All right, everybody, back to the show.
Peace! So, man, I don't want to be that guy, bro, but Young, let me have these Bugs Bunny socks, because I got to mention, you know, shirt, whatever.
Go for it. I want this pin.
Episode 81, Naruto, Shippuden, and Normies, we are. Here we go.
Yes.
Last thing we didn't mention last time was Ebisu showed up with his crows.
I think Ebisu usually wears the fucking...
Yeah,
he usually wears a bandana.
Yeah, I didn't know that he was the same guy.
Yeah.
The guy that trained Naruto, way back when, or whatever.
No, that's Ibiki.
That's Ibiki?
Yeah.
Okay, never mind.
No. Oh my god, I'm fucking up the names. I'm so sorry.
Too many names.
Hold on.
This guy's Ibisu. That's the guy that trained Naruto.
Okay. That was Ibisu?
Yeah.
So... Or did they get the subtitles wrong?
So, he is Ibisu.
The guy's name is Ibisu.
And he's Konohamaru's, like, guardian guy.
Ibiki is the other guy.
This is not a market substitute for Shippuden. Please support the official release. Support us on Patreon. You help us do what we do for a living. We are not able to do this without you wonderful folks on Patreon. And you wonderful folks on YouTube, hit the like button and comment. If you are enjoying these episodes,
yeehaw!
Run and heed do fillers.
Yes, we do.
Only on Patreon though. They live in the vault. Check out the vault.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, man. We just saw Shippuden. The ones all y'all missed. It was fucking dope, man. We got to see Asuma. Hey, bro. Fuck, I found out about
that
shit.
That come for you guys more.
Yeah, because, dude, I found out about that.
We should have watched that filler.
I found out about the thing, like, 2 days before. I was like, all right, I got to watch it.
I feel like whatever happened in whatever you guys just watched, I feel like that was kind of important. I feel like we should have watched
it. Dude, it was. It was way better than the Tetsu Bridge, let me tell you that right now.
Nahida and Mickey?
See, I was going to say something to Nahida and
Mickey. Always have my thumb over there.
Like, I don't want to say something.
Like, whenever I talk, I press it.
Hey, all I gotta say is that whole filler arc was way better than Tenshi Bridge, bro. Real talk.
Yeah, that's fucked up, bro. Orochimaru wasn't in that filler arc, though.
We saw Orochimaru in fillers.
Yeah.
He was in that one?
No, it was in the, Naruto's fillers. Not in this one.
Not Shippuden, are you sure?
So, my theory on who the guy is with the nose studs, can I say it? Can I say what I think is...
As long as it's not a spoiler as a theory,
yeah, sure.
You can.
All right, go.
Well, we've heard this name only like a couple times, maybe like two or three times so far. I don't know how, but I think it's Madara.
Madara Uchiha.
Uchiha, yeah, because we've heard the name in the beginning of this, and then the fox mentioned it again.
Isn't he dead?
I am not gonna say anything.
Madara Uchiha's dead.
Yes, but like I don't. Yeah, but like I don't know. Maybe.
We have heard the name.
That's the only thing.
I know who that is. I'm not gonna say anything either.
Cool.
I actually got spoiled on that too.
Wait, then I'm wrong. Christ.
No, you're not. Yes, you are.
What the fuck, Nahida?
I'm fucking with you.
All right, I guess we are starting. We are
this
getting
is why
a world
I close
clock
my ears
up.
Around
I can't
the
hear people.
I am wrong. Nahida just informed me that.
And this
I'm
one,
wrong,
and this
so
one, and this one, this one, I was kind of ruined because of.
Jesus Christ, bro.
Can you just stop? Stop telling people what you guys spoiled on. Stop telling us.
I feel like we go on the same.
Just tell the fans, and they're the ones we didn't describe. Don't tell us.
I'm not telling you anything. If anything.
So it's not. That wasn't a spoiler.
No,
it's not Madara. Madara Chot
Somebody unmute themselves. Oh, starting right off. Oh,
intro immediately. Do your things, everybody. Pick your nose. Scratch your dick.
I'm gonna kiss my dog.
Scratch your vaginas.
No, man, you're gonna wake him up.
Alice isn't asleep.
Supposed to kill a fucking fire, bruh. There you go.
Is this a new one?
I was trying to invite KB to watch the reactions because he's home. But he just...
What did he say? He's like, no.
He was like...
Wait, what did he...
He was, and then he was like, I don't want to jump into the dynamics that you guys have already built in. I'm not going to vibe in. I was like, you're thinking way too hard on this, but that's fine.
No, he was actually pretty right, I'll be honest.
Oh, KB.
Yeah, he was actually
and
pretty
he doesn't
right,
wake up
yeah,
at
8 Preeti and KB jump in on it.
And he doesn't wake up.
Maybe like a big group reaction for shipping in. That'd be fun, bro.
Yeah, he's seen all of the shipping in. Think he's debating to watch Baruto because he heard it's actually getting good.
Oh yeah, not if he's already seen ships. There he is. You see him? Yeah, I just saw it too.
So I guess we are now finding out who he is in this arc if they didn't reveal his face.
Is it cold or not in here? Jesus.
This is different, bro.
This is different. So he's running past everybody, right?
Was
it always there?
No, they changed it up because they do that, bro, when things change. No, I think it's so different because
they're gonna kiss.
Naruto! Oh, we're back here! We're back here! This is what I'm living for.
Yamato!
This part's so...
Shouts out to
Kakashi!
Shouts out to Rob.
Kakashi! For life!
We've given Rob enough shoutouts.
They need it now.
They do.
But if I concentrate too much on that, my Rasengan doesn't turn out right.
Aw, they're getting the sad rain.
Yeah.
They're getting the sad rain now.
We believe that you are the only shinobi who can surpass the fourth Hokage.
Kakashi-sensei had such high hopes for me, but it turns out I'm a complete failure.
You think we should stop the training? Well, if that's what he wants to do. The imagery.
Aww.
Sasuke.
I don't have any more time to waste.
You got that second win, bro.
All you gotta do is think for a bit.
Let's get it.
Whoa.
Oh, wow.
You've been watching this whole time.
And then the guitar riff. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Yamato, where you at, bro? Yama finger.
We got another one that's turning into the 9 tails.
Dogpile him.
That's like three tails.
Three tails. Oh,
shit.
Captain Yamato!
Tenzo! Oh, shit!
I keep forgetting. I want to start calling him Tenzo.
What? It's like little fucking snakes.
Only one person has snakes.
This is sick.
But they are kind of
like they're like Hydra dragons or some shit.
Yeah.
You okay?
Me.
This feels a lot like Death Rain, doesn't it?
Wow.
You just achieved what the average ninja would take 4,800 hours to do.
Dang.
I guess that's still
a lot of 48 hours.
And it feels like 200 shadow clones is my limit. I'm never gonna be able to master it.
Bro, he just gave you, like, props.
You're halfway there.
The base for a Sangun in the first place. It's just too much.
You're unusually negative.
Yeah, it's the weather, bro. It's the weather.
My Naruto's an empath.
Ugh. Oh, you mean you're an umbrella out of a bat.
Catch cool. What? Good guy side.
So cute!
Batbrella.
Good guy side.
I love Sai.
Mastering difficult skills has never been Naruto's strong suit. Training only Naruto can do. Incorporating a change in chakra nature into a jutsu by itself. Is a difficult enough hurdle to get over. To try and add something to it now, especially for someone like Naruto, may be impossible.
Come on!
Sai, give us some good words, Sai.
Depression's in the air.
But this is his arc, right?
You have a point. Naruto is an idiot. He's a clumsy, tactless fool.
Ooh!
For him to perfect something as intricate as a modification of the Rasengan, Meanwhile, the village is forming platoons to fend off the Akatsuki. This is a total waste of manpower.
Oh, what are you all?
I'm about to punch you, bro.
Kage expects from a no-talent like Naruto.
Damn. Oh, shit.
Say another word, and I'll knock you out.
Okay, Sai's up to something.
And exactly what do you know about Naruto anyway? Sure, Naruto's not the brightest guy. He's clumsy, he goofs off, and he's a bird brain. He's saved our butts more times than I can even count.
That was perfectly done, Sai. That was perfectly done.
Yeah, he did this on purpose to give her the motivation and him the motivation.
Yeah, because she was like negative too.
What the? You're smiling? Oh,
I love Sai.
There's no need for that. Sometimes the knowledge found in books can be fairly useful.
How to manipulate a thought.
Understanding people's feelings series.
Huh?
When words can mean the opposite of how you feel.
Aww.
The whole book.
How to win friends and influence people.
I understand just how completely you believe in Naruto.
Sai's on some cards.
Yeah.
You tricked me, Sai?
Yep.
It would be a shame if Naruto had to eat all those awful mud balls of yours and didn't get any results.
Ah,
Sai.
What do you mean by mud balls? You know, before you go reading the true feelings of others, maybe you should figure out how to talk about your own.
I love Sai.
Okay, let's marry Sai.
I just kind of like Sai. You guys are like on his dick.
Dude, he was
you
really
see
awesome.
You look at this. This is so beautiful. What a good human being.
Okay, I'm sorry. He's great. He's amazing.
He understands where he came from. He had no feelings. I know.
Could
that
you
is true.
Look to the left and the right at the same time?
If you're asking me, yeah, I guess it's doable.
Huh?
Shadow clone jutsu.
Oh my god! Oh! Two Kakashis!
Oh god.
Animation is so well done right now, y'all.
I get it!
What does he get?
They're like glowing in the ring. What do you get?
Fuck you bitches! I hate them so much, I hope Shigemaru fucking stabs you in the heart!
That's the two tail.
Is that her?
Yeah.
You went to the trouble of calling us back here just to seal the two tails?
It will take 3 days.
Oh man, it's raining where we are.
Shut up.
But I was this close to slaughtering those leaf morons.
The leaf aren't heathens.
Oh.
They venerate their ancestors.
That's him.
One could say their motives for fighting are just as valid as yours.
Huh? How dare you?
Yeah,
are you
definitely
trying to
believe.
Insult me?
Commending the
but
enemy.
I intend to ridicule the reasons why you do battle. You and I are birds of a feather. It doesn't matter what you use to justify war. Religion, philosophy, resources, land, revenge, love, even a woman. No matter how trivial your motives, there will always be war. Human instinct seeks conflict.
This is not a kid show.
This motherfucker's spitting.
I don't intend to devote my all to this organization, alright?
So long as you're affiliated with the Akatsuki, you will contribute to its goals. Once
the
thing
is
achieved, your own wishes will be swiftly granted as well.
Yeah, this is Kakazu. And fighting for money is the motivation I hate most.
Our immediate ambition is indeed financial.
After Toby, I'm the second newest member of the team. So I've heard
Toby!
What's the true goal from you?
Are you so kidding? I suppose it's about time I told. The Akatsuki's ultimate objective will be accomplished in stages.
Step one, make money.
The first being money.
Phase one? Collect other
money. Use that money to assemble the first mercenary shinobi army the world has seen.
Oh, shit.
What? You want to become the ruler of some tiny village that doesn't have a host
bro,
nation to support it?
He's still no one to shut up. He's questioning everything.
A village supported by a host nation. For a nation that possesses a powerful ninja village, shinobi business plays a key role in their profit structure. They support that nation's economy, not the other way around. In other words, in order for that nation to have steady revenue, war becomes a necessary evil.
Wow. This is real world as fuck! Wow.
The villagers have downsized to save money, and many shinobi have lost their jobs. They risk their lives for the sake of their land. drastically, it won't be able to protect itself from a sudden conflict. We will not align ourselves to any nation and only mobilize the necessary number of Shinobi at the appropriate time. An organization that will accept money for contracts of war, exclusively cornering the entire war market. Then we will use the tamed beasts to cause new wars altogether.
What?
That's what they want to do? That's everything. Cat's out of the bag.
This is real world as fuck. What is the true goal?
Tell us.
Which is?
World domination.
Of course.
Okay.
All right. Evil.
Every villain is lemons.
Is this supposed to be so much real world like that we're supposed to be questioning it?
That was very real world like. Yes.
Like how?
No more great wars. You... There's only smaller conflicts.
Mm-hmm. Like this happened after World War II, bro. No more great wars.
Yeah. Yep.
After World War II, no more great wars.
This was.
Ma'am.
Holy shit.
What about Kuranai?
I'll tell her.
Notify everyone else regarding the funeral services. I will inform Kuranai.
No. I'll do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to tell her myself.
Yeah, that'd be more appropriate.
I have a message for her.
Can we just make Shikamaru the main character, please? He's so fucking cool. He's just like, come on.
Y'all forget about him?
Yeah, he cool too.
Out here fucking.
Right. Rasengan! Yeah. I think I'm finally getting the hang of this thing!
Oh shit! Oh, is he doing it?
He is doing the thing.
So that's what your bright idea was, huh?
Tornado.
I realized I was gonna need a second set of hands if I was ever gonna handle the wind change in chakra nature. And then I can divide up the responsibility.
He just tried this?
Of course, only Naruto has both the chakra and the skill with shadow clones for a method like that to work. I couldn't accomplish that.
Gotcha.
I bet even the fourth Hokage couldn't. Just what I'd expect from a ninja like you, Naruto. But I think I've really started to take a liking
just
to you
now.
You don't love me?
Don't say throw stuff like that out of the blue! Freak me out!
I don't mean it like that. There aren't words to express how I feel.
This is fucking hilarious.
Oh my god, that's so funny.
What are those two doing?
Is this how you guys feel?
Oh, here we go. Shit. Oh no.
What's going on?
They're having fun.
Also, did Naruto just try to have a third clone help him? Like, he just came.
I think he's having each one do like two together.
Call off the training and return immediately. What's happened?
War.
Tell him.
Oh, this is gonna hurt him too, I bet, bro.
He's gonna think of Shikamaru immediately.
Yamato usually keeps it real.
Yeah.
Well, make no mince words.
Asuma Sarutobi.
They know already. Just with those words.
Damn. It's all gonna hit so hard.
Has been killed.
That's it. That was quick!
That felt really quick.
Man, I can't even imagine giving that kind of news.
It's not easy.
Did that this episode
was a mix
seem
of, like,
short?
Fun.
It seems so quick to
so
me.
So quick.
So... The Cuts game missed world domination.
World domination. Hey, in a nutshell, there's a lot more.
Oh yeah. I just want to ask all the kids that watched this at a young age. I'm not saying y'all are rocket science or anything like that, but did you guys really grasp what the fuck they were talking about? Because as an adult, I'm just like, what the fuck?
I think you gotta give them more credit than.
I mean, they're talking about like wars and proxy wars, like literally the whole idea when he said, "Hey, there were the last great wars are gone, and then these are smaller wars." I didn't really figure that out until, like, I would say a couple, like, a little bit ago, that the last great war was World War II, and then all the other wars that we fought ever since we've been in the small proxy wars. And they did a really, really good job of explaining that shit. They really did a really good job of explaining how countries fight for profit nowadays, that the war economy is a huge fucking deal. And wow, did he fucking hit the nerve when he was like, we're gonna be a fucking army that's gonna be, he said, finances first. After finances, we use that to assemble, we use that to make a big mercenary army that will help these other small proxy wars win. They can take on the other big guys.
Yeah.
And their end goal from all that is to have a monopoly on all the wars. Like, fucking genius.
Yeah, they're essentially making like a paramilitary organization. Mm-hmm. I think, to your point, I think kids did. Hey, sound is off.
Okay.
My back is just.
To Naheed's point, I think kids did. Can you hear me, Navi?
Yeah.
I think kids did understand it to some extent, but as you get older, you always understand things a little bit more, and like, you can see this through a different lens now, but like, yeah, proxy wars are kind of what makes the world go round now. There's never going to be a big old World War III. It's just going to be little conflicts that like countries are funding, but like this...
Companies make weapons, they give them to the enemies, and then we go fight the enemy.
Yeah.
Their goal is essentially, I think they feel like it's...
I'm sorry.
It's like they're liberating.
Yeah. They don't give them to the enemy.
When he was saying the world domination, it just immediately reminded me of Pinky and the Brain. Did you guys watch
it? Yes,
I was like, to take over the world! I was like, yes.
Dude,
that's the goal.
Yeah, sorry.
Hey, that whole speech was fucking awesome.
It was. It really
you
was.
Know how like when villains say their evil plan, thank goodness Hedon was just like, what are we doing? It's like, alright, let me explain everything.
You fucking child.
So there was a lot revealed because he also said like, oh, like we're doing this for revenge, land, resources.
Itachi's was love.
Itachi's was love?
Itachi's was love.
Yeah.
I was wondering,
because he was
first person and then
what?
I thought that was a woman at the end. That was Itachi.
No.
I was like, love, who's this girl?
No,
this Akatsuki girl.
And that's why, like, maybe, I like, remember, I don't know, guys.
And then a whim with Deidara.
Yeah, a whim.
Whim was Deidara.
Because he's like, art is an explosion.
Yeah, whim with Deidara. I wish I could go, if you want to go back, yeah.
They essentially just describe every Akatsuki's motivation.
Are there any women in the Akatsuki?
I don't know, we'll see. But, like, that shit was, hey, bro, that shit was so sick. I'm just saying, like,
but yeah, guys, remember I had that stupid theory?
There you go, it was right there.
That, like, Itachi killed his family because of, like, love, or he had to do it, or maybe hit his family or something. I don't know.
Yeah, they, essentially...
Okay, right. Alright, you do battle. All birds, after all, you and I are birds of... Dude.
Yeah, birds of a feather. This is all the reasons that they use to justify war, essentially.
Religion, philosophy, there you go.
Yeah.
Oh, we missed it, go back.
Revenge, resources, land.
Revenge,
everybody
love.
Just has
revenge
something to rationalize.
No, revenge was war. Revenge was Shark Boy. Revenge was Shark Boy.
Let's see. We're gonna pause it and do a play by play.
Yeah, I'm sorry guys, we're gonna do it. I know we usually don't do this.
I'm curious, you know.
Oh, that's what's happening?
Yeah, bro.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we'll explain it to you as we get up. Okay, hey. Religion was Hedon.
Yeah, okay, religion.
He's the one that's like, oh, he's always quoting the Bible.
And then he's philosophy.
Who is that?
The main guy.
Really?
Yeah, he's philosophy. He's going to philosopher now.
Okay. Do you think the
philosophy,
main guy...
Resources?
Resources is Kakazu, because he's always about the money. He's like a financial officer.
Okay. Land?
Land is the Venus flytrap guy.
Venus flytrap looking dude. Looks sick as fuck.
Revenge
that's
is
Shark Boy. Same.
And then, yeah, love is Itachi.
Which,
again,
is
he looks like
Itachi?
A chick.
And then women's Deidara.
Itachi!
Women's Deidara. Who the fuck is Toby?
Deidara is Wim.
Is Toby an Akatsuki member?
He said the second one to come in was Hedon, then right after that was Toby. He said that in the beginning.
Okay. Do you think the main guy is, because I'm looking at his eyes, well, I've never seen that before. Like, how the Sharingan is like, for the Uchiha clan.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking maybe he's from some clan that's like
he got some sort
eyes.
Of Kekkigen
cat. He's gone or like some clan that's like doesn't exist anymore. Maybe he's like the last of his clan too.
Yeah,
it's the robot clan.
Well, I thought he might have been Madara Chot, but man, I don't think he is. So
I'll get back to the other part of the episode. This was so good. This was so freaking good.
Yeah, this is like all the information.
And they're waiting for the five villages to collapse. I'm sorry. We got a lot of skilled ninjas and shinobis and stuff.
So,
I know there's wards and everything, but can you really expect you can take down all five villages to collapse?
Again, okay. I'm not.
I mean,
not
eventually.
Pip out these fillers again, but going back to the fillers, that's one thing they were talking about. They did in the Naruto fillers too, where they talked about all these small villages and how. And this was actually the star one too. We recently saw. Was that that was from Naruto,
mm-hmm.
where like there was a star village and they
there's
were
a land of tea.
Land of no, it was well, there was a star village basically, but they were trying to become. They had a Hoshikage and they were trying to become one of the great villages to be like the other villages, but they couldn't because they just didn't have enough resources. Again, goes back to money. You need money and finances in this world, and you need something you just kind of like
now being introduced that finances and money is a huge thing. We never got the scene.
I don't know who or how many people told us to skip that bout of episodes, but I feel like we were misled. I feel like we should have seen
that. Unmute.
I think it's a good, there were good fillers to see, but it still wasn't technically canon, but it just helps flesh out the world more.
Yeah, it does. Especially when you're a little confused that a little bit, because I was confused on some things.
I heard that there's fillers about, fucking Kakashi and, Orochimaru and shit. I don't want to skip those.
I'm not skipping those for sure, man. I got to see two Kakashis in this episode. That was really nice.
Yeah, why would we want to skip those?
Easy with your fantasies, girl.
Calm down.
Hey, man, you pointed out Kuro and I while in the saddest moment, and Runai is just saying to Kakashi, and you're telling us to calm down. Calm down on Kuronoi.
He's like, man, she fine as fuck.
Yeah, while we are crying. And then it was on the side note, Kuronoi is fine as fuck. I was like, when we say something, that's totally opposite. And you just change the mood. In the middle of us crying, I was like, Kuronoi is fine as fuck. Okay, thanks, Surge.
I mean, she's fine,
calm down. Let's cry over one thing.
But I was going to say, I really liked seeing the Sai part in the beginning of the episode. I want Sai to either be my best friend or if I was with Nahid and a boyfriend.
He is. His character is
that boy would not like you.
And then his umbrella. And he's so cute that he just left it on Sakura.
Anyway, he saw Sakura down and negative, but then he brought her out of it and made an umbrella for her. And just using a word, he has come
just
so
like
far
you are a sucker
so
for any woman who is in a tight ass dress.
So
yep, that one. Right. Titties. Got it. So he's developing great for what he was before and what he is now. We hated him in the beginning.
And he knows how to make jokes now.
Dude, right now we're talking about Sai. Sai is in this episode. We're not going to talk about characters who are not in this episode. So we're talking about Sai in this episode.
Sai is
his development's great.
He's cool. Sai, he had an arc. He had a good arc. He developed feelings. It was cool. He's good. He's amazing.
He's
cool.
No, dude, he's
amazing. Exactly. That's the cute part. He didn't know.
Yeah, I think he's amazing.
Originally, when he saw him, we hated him.
Cool.
His fake smile, everything. And now he's slowly learning to a point where
he
knows what
Sakura
was feeling and how to get out of that negativity. And he did a great job. And he left. He's learning.
No,
I get it.
He's come a long way.
Other people more.
You gotta understand that, bro. He's almost like a goddamn robot. He has no feelings. He never had any. It was hard for him to get these. He's reading books to figure this shit out, which
he's
is really, really cute.
It's amazing. That bat thing was so cute. I still think. But I'm glad, just a couple things, what Katsuki plan is, because that's the plan I've been waiting to hear. It's what is the purpose of Katsuki? What are they really trying to do? And they really, it was really
and
well put.
Allows,
a lot
more
of information and
stuff. It's okay.
And also, man, hey, bruh, come on, man, he's a badass ninja man. He can make fucking things out of drawings and shit, bro. He can draw a goddamn cannon if he
the
wanted
evil
to. Make cannon
world
come
domination.
Out of that shit. He's like green. He's like
that is a cool jutsu.
He's like Green Lantern in a weird
over
way.
The
you
world.
Know?
I did not expect it to end with a cliche world domination, but then I was like, okay, yeah, that makes sense.
I bet in the dub it sounds different. Or sub.
Probably.
World domination.
Yeah. They try to take over the world.
Third step.
We saw Naruto kind of figure out he needed a third clone to help him. He was making clones and everything, but there were groups in two. He didn't realize they had to be in groups of three now.
Yeah. Sometimes the simplest solutions are the answer, and you don't think of it while you're in the heat of the moment. So it's good that right when he thought of it, though, now they're pulling him out. So yeah. If Kakashi and Yamato are spending all this time training Naruto, while as Sai was saying some truth, all of Akatsuki's closing in, and we don't have time for these resources. Obviously, they're putting a lot of stake in the boy.
They are.
He's got to deliver.
Huge stake in the boy.
They gotta, and I think it's not only that. He has to help protect the village, but he is the main target, so he gotta protect himself as well. In the end of the day, he have to protect himself, so
this training is needed for Naruto because at the end of the day, there's only so much that others can do for him. He has to stand up for himself.
They're going to use the tailed beasts to wage war. Like, what the fuck does that mean? Are they going to, like, let him out? Like,
oh, like give back the villages?
See, I thought they were utilizing their power to, yeah, like, summon something, but I guess they're going to just, like, unleash him.
Maybe they're like the secret weapon to help you in the war, or maybe, like, you know, bargaining tools to give you, like, your village back or something.
Just to give you an idea, maybe it's kind of like, yo, we're going to set this off and blame it on this guy so these guys fight each other.
It takes 3 days, too, by the way.
Think they could transplant it into somebody else that wasn't a Jinchuriki?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I'm sure they could. I mean, if you can put it in anybody.
And like, seal it, yeah.
Because, I mean, that's how the whole proxy war, like, they're going to, they have the weapons, now they're going to give it to somebody, and then that person is going to attack somebody else, and it's just...
I'm surprised they don't give it to themselves, since there's, like, 10 of them.
Oh, shit. Fuck.
There's 10 of them and 10 tailed beasts. Oh, I don't know how many there are. There's at least 9. I assume they would give it to themselves, but maybe they're not all worthy to wield that power. So I don't know. They're doing something with them. I don't know if they're going to unleash them or
they would want to be like more managerial.
Yeah. Shikamaru is going to be the one to talk to Kurenai.
Yeah, that's more appropriate than Tsunade.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so watch the next episode.
Yeah, let's do it.
Bye. Catch you guys on the flip side.
Bye.
Bye. I think I'm going to drop the show, guys.
Yeah, me too.
I got to go pee. I'll be right back.
Some people are using the bathroom, Nubby.